some reason, for an entire year or so, we didn't hear much from MzVee, except photos of her traveling the world, enjoying her life. And we had a good time some time back, 2 years ago, I think.
Yeah.
And then now you are here. MzVee, how are you doing?
I am fabulous.
You look lovely, by the way.
You too.
I love the hair and everything
Merci
else.
Merci beaucoup.
But where have you been? What have you been up to?
Like you said, I have been traveling, I've been having fun. But really, 2019 was more of a self-finding, rejuvenation, positive thinking, self-actualization year for me.
When you say self-finding, you didn't know who you were in the previous years?
I did, but you know, as you grow up, you just have so many things happen to you at a point at once.
Mm-hmm.
And then you ask yourself so many questions. And that's when, you know, you start to rethink certain things.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
what were some of the
year,
things that were happening to you? And what questions did you ask yourself? We want to know.
Well, for about 2 years, say 2017, 2018, I was super depressed.
Huh?
I was super, super, super depressed.
2017, 2018?
Yep.
2018 was when you went to BET?
No,
or
2016.
Or was it 2017? 2016?
Yes.
So after that?
Yes.
2017, 2018?
Yes.
What made you depressed?
It was just things happening personally, and it happened to affect my relationship with work, things happening at work. You know, when things are happening to you personally, unfortunately, there's a spillover. So it starts to affect everything around you. And that's what 2017, 2018 was.
Can we pry a bit and find out what are some of these personal things that you were going through? Was it relationship-wise?
Relationship-wise, family-wise, and just me, myself.
You weren't happy with where you were?
Oh, I was very content. I was happy, but you know, we're human. We want more.
Mm-hmm.
And aside that, human beings have problems from time to time. But I think it's a good thing I went through what I went through, because 2019 made me realize that I am a very strong person.
Mm-hmm.
And it made me realize how confident I am and that I can basically conquer the world.
2 years of depression,
yeah,
and this affected your work. In what way?
It affected my relationships with people at work, for example, because I really did pull away.
From everyone?
Yes, from everyone. People at work didn't even know what was going on with me. Because I'm the type, I'm very private. If you know this,
I
am super, super private. It takes a lot for me to come out and tell someone, oh, so-and-so is happening with me. So I basically coiled up in my shell, and I was there for 2 years battling this. And a lot of people go through this. Musicians go through this.
Yeah.
And people don't know.
Yeah.
Because, you know, they're in the limelight. They don't want to come and say, and this is happening with me, and that's happening with me. They'll feel some type of way about it. So they just keep quiet. I think I saw a video of Papi Kojo also talking about depression. And it's a problem, because I realized that, wow, the females in the industry, there was really no one else I could talk to who could relate to what I was saying. Aside
Efia. You didn't have friends?
No, aside Efia. Trust me, the females in the industry, we are very like, we wake up, do our thing, and then go back home. We are not together
not like together.
The guys are.
Yeah.
So it was really tough. But Efia, I've always looked up to her. She's become like a sister to me. So she's one person who really helped me.
So you opened up to her?
Yes, I did. We spoke a lot. A lot. Almost always.
Wow.
Yes.
And she helped?
She did.
But you had a team. I mean, I'm sure that your team consisted of probably a psychologist and all of that. Maybe.
No, I don't have a psychologist.
You never
team,
saw a psychologist? No, did you ever see a psychologist?
No,
through?
I didn't.
Efia was your psychologist.
She was, you know, because you need someone like you who can relate. She's a female musician. She's powerful. And when we started talking, I realized, oh, okay, so it's not just me. She's sort of been through a phase that people even don't know about.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we were able to talk, and it was very helpful.
So,
and in the time, I got closer to my family, because I was estranged from my family for about 7 years.
Why was that so?
I don't know. I was just
Was it work?
Work was part of it. I hardly saw family. I hardly hung out with family. And it took a toll on me.
Mm.
Yeah, it took a toll on me. So, yeah. Efia, family, some friends.
Doesn't mean you were not prepared for the music industry when it started. Because I remember
I think,
you were in a group.
Yeah.
And then for some reason, the group didn't happen anymore. And then you signed on to Lynx.
Yeah.